Hontori, Hishmahori, Kurtori, Dalti, Agasir Dalti, Agas R. A. Specialta and of Ontahertonio Reardon, Eardalton Scotsa. Ta falta the gap in air law at all co-specialta Agas Coastarul at all on and off. Cade is Shapta Kuik Blino Hin, a whole issue on Cade Dalta Stock 3 Nagathi Isha. Father Pat, teachers, parents, visitors, pupils and past pupils, and our special guest, Father Tony, a past pupil of Dundee School. You are all very welcome here today on this very special historic day. You are 175 years ago today, the first pupil walked through the gates of this school. Today, we will celebrate 175 years of teaching and learning in Dundee National School in Kilmichael. We will remember many past pupils and their families of past pupils who are now spread across the globe, perhaps unaware of what is happening here today, unless they follow social media, of course. We will begin our celebrations by offering the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass.
In anam an aher, agus an vic, agus an spirit naev. The Lord be with you. Good morning. I hope you're all feeling as welcome as I am. I don't know how many people have travelled. How many people have travelled outside of Kilmichael this morning? Hands up. Lava sauce. Keep them up. Top of the class. A few more. So welcome and welcome one and all. In our first reading this morning, St. Paul writing to the Romans reminds us that God is good and that God has been kind to us. And I think as we gather this morning in our memories and looking as well at this beautiful bunch, how many of you are there?
60.
How many?
60.
Oh, that's a big bunch. And looking at your faces, it's obviously that God is good. So as we begin this Mass, get ready to listen to God's word and to give thanks to God for all the blessings in our lives and to continue to pray God's blessing on this school and this community. Conscious that we don't always remember God's blessing or don't always follow his prompting in our lives, we pause for a moment and ask for God's mercy and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. In my thoughts, in my most grievous fault. Care for, I ask, Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. Amen.
So are we going to have a hymn? In the beginning was love.
Yeah. Will we start with our hymn or the gifts?
The gifts and symbols.
Gifts and symbols.
The old heavy key that unlocked the door of Dromley School 175 years ago today, thereby opening up access to education for generations of children. The 1920 roll book recalling a very significant point in local and national history. The school bell that continues to call children to class and play. A football symbolising the school's sporting ethos and marking Kilmichael's long involvement with the GAA. A CD of music and song, some newly composed and performed by children, representing Drumlee's great interest in music and the arts. Drumlee in S. Kilmichael spans three centuries. Our re-edited book containing our history, memories of past pupils and teachers, and a host of photographs.
Mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us all to everlasting life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we who call out to you this morning may, at your prompting, discern what is right, and by your help and guidance, do it. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. So we have our first reading, please.
First reading from Romans 12. Dear friends, God is good. So I beg you to offer your bodies to him as a living sacrifice, pure and pleasing. That's the most sensible way to serve God. Don't be like the people of this world, but let God change the way you think. Then you'll know how to do everything that is good and pleasing to him. I realize how kind God has been to me, and so I tell each of you not to think you are better than you really are. Use good sense and measure yourself by the amount of faith that God has given you. A body is made up of many parts, and each of them has its own use. That's how it is with us. There are many of us, but we each are part of the body of Christ, as well as part of one another. God has also given us, each of us, different gifts to use. If we can prophesy, we should do it according to the amount of faith we have. If we can serve others, we should serve. If we can teach, we should teach. If we can encourage others, we should encourage them. If we can give, we should be generous. If we are leaders, we should do our best. If we are good to others, we should do it cheerfully. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I'm the Lord of sea and sky. I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. of wind and flame. I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will save. On his bread I will provide, till their hearts are satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my hand.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Every year, the parents of Jesus used to go to Jerusalem for the feast of the Passover. When he was 12 years old, they went up to the feast as usual. When they were on their way home after the feast, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem without his parents knowing it. They assumed he was with the caravan. And it was only after a day's journey that they went to look for him among their relations and acquaintances. When they failed to find him, they went back to Jerusalem looking for him everywhere. 3 days later, they found him in the temple, sitting there amongst the doctors, listening to them and asking them questions. And all those who heard him were astounded at his intelligence and his replies. They were overcome when they saw him. And his mother said to him, "My child, why have you done this to us? See how worried your father and I have been looking for you." "Why were you looking for me?" he replied. "Did you not know that I must be busy about my father's affairs?" But they did not understand what he meant. He then went down with them and came to Jerusalem and lived under their authority. His mother stored up all these things in her heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
You're very sweet singers. Do you go on tour at all? I think I might hire you out some evening. You're very, very, very sweet. And tell me, do you like coming to school on Saturday morning? Might be something we could try out a bit longer, could it? Maybe next Saturday?
No!
Did your parents like bringing you to school on Saturday morning, I wonder?
No.
No. I think the next board of management meeting, you can discuss coming to that, because the teachers love coming to school on Saturday. They love coming to school on Saturday. Well, thanks again for inviting me and to be part of the celebration. Any school is hugely significant in lives of people. For all of us, and especially now these boys and girls, it takes up 8 years of our lives at a very formative stage, where we come Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and maybe now Saturdays. And we grow and we play and we learn. And your mummies and daddies bring you So it's a big part of their lives. How many people walk to school now? Anyone walk? No. How many come by bus? And how many come with mommy and daddy in the car? No one comes in a tractor anymore, no? And it's a big part, so it's a big part of your lives, it's a big part of parents' lives, it's a big part of teachers' lives, because careers are, you know, you think you're in school a long time, but teachers can be 30 years in school. 25. So it takes up a lot of our lives. It takes up a lot of our lives, and it's a good place, and it's part of life. And there's other things that go on, because you go home in the evening, I hope, and you play and you do little jobs for mommy and daddy. And in the summertime, parents have a little break from bringing you and collecting you. And I'm told teachers get a holiday for a month or two, where they go and read and study and train and do all sorts of things like that. So it's good that we gather here this morning to acknowledge the role that all of us play in such a school. And all the more significant that we gather and remember that this particular school has a long history, and that previous generations have sustained it and have been part of, and it's been part of their lives, and they have been part of the life of the school and have handed it on to us, and we continue to hand it on, hopefully for many, many more generations. The gospel reading that Father Pat just read of the country boy Jesus and his parents, just like your parents bring you to school, his parents, Mary and Joseph, took him up to the big city. Have you gone on school tours? Yeah. Yeah? Do you like school tours?
Yeah. Yeah.
Where's the furthest you've gone? Wow. What'd you go to see there?
Wow.
You went to Wicklow? Excellent. So you can imagine the long journey. So Jesus goes up to the big city, Jerusalem, from the small place where he lived. It was not too unlike Kilmichael, small little place. And they go up to the big city because it was part of their religion every year to go up to the temple and be part of the big festival, the big novena up in the big city. And he gets lost. And when they go searching for him, where do they find him? They find him with the people that have all the qualifications and in the big school up in the city. Now, if you went to Dublin, would you go running off and find a school? I'm not sure. You'd probably go off and find something else to do. But I think there's something important in that story, in that there was the boy who had come from, as I say, the small place of Nazareth, and he is found with the people with the learning and the qualifications, and he's able to engage with them, and he's able to be part of that world. But he's able to engage with them because he has had another form of education that has started before he met the learned people. He has had a formation and an education that began at home. And there is a very important difference between qualification and learning, and between the wisdom and values that we get in other settings, particularly the home. You know the old joke they tell in Montanotti of the two mothers, and the two sons are out swimming, and the mother looks at her son and she goes, "Help, help, help! My son, the engineer, is drowning." And the other mother goes, "It's okay, it's okay. My son, the doctor, will save him." Qualifications are really, really important. And education and formal education are really, really, really important. And that you learn and your sigma T's and your micro T's and all those things, and learning to read and write and all the things that you will get. And you will go on, all of you, I'm sure, to secondary school, and you'll go on to college and university. And all those things are really, really important. But a school and a primary school is doing something more important too. It is recognizing that there is more to life than just pieces of paper and form of acquiring of education. There is the learning how to be in the world. And as I say, that has started before you came in the gates of this school. And it continues when you go home in the evening, and it continues after you leave the school. And you have teachers here in the school, but you never mightn't realize it, but your mammy and daddy are teaching you every day, and your brothers and sisters, how to share, how to care, how to know what's important in life. And I think it's important that parents realize that role more and more, because there's a tendency to let more and more of the job to schools, and schools and teachers, I don't know how you cope. You're asked to do, there's new bits added onto curriculum every year, and you're asked to teach them this and teach them how to cross the road safely, and you're asked to do this and then that next program with them and all these kind of things. But parents have to continue to nurture and keep the home a place where children feel part of the family, where they learn to participate, and where they're protected maybe from some of the things that undermine that. Like, we all like give iPads and me pads and you pads and she pads and they pads and internet and internet and all those sorts of things and television. Yeah. So you just need to kind of watch how we use those things. Make sure we have meals together. And it's not a bad thing for a family to pray together. I remember when I was growing up, we used to have the rosary. I'm sure that I participated very often. It was often a case where we laughed and joked a little bit. It was kind of a little bit long, but it was a good practice because we prayed. We mightn't have prayed well, but we prayed. And maybe it's not the rosary is the thing to do, but, you know, maybe just, I think a very simple thing is that every family should, when it eats, just to say a simple grace before meals. Just to thank God and to acknowledge God and to acknowledge the blessings in our lives. The other part of that gospel story is that the parents, they have done their bit, Mary and Joseph, good parents. They've brought their child, but they don't fully understand where he's going. And isn't that so true, that children are not things that we own or can control? That their destiny, we're part of it, but we can't control it. And that their futures are somehow out of our hands, and we have hopes maybe and worries, but it is the job of parents to trust that what they're getting here at home and in school will prepare them for the life journey that is ahead of them. And so there is a difficulty there for parents maybe, and to try and trust God, that God is working with you, and that there is a time where their life and their choices will go in directions maybe that will surprise you, and that they must choose what and how they will be in the world, like all of us have had to do. So as we celebrate this great school and all the people who have worked to maintain it and who have been part of it, and all the boards of management and the principals who have guided it and led it, and who have obviously transformed it from what it was 30 years ago or more. We give thanks for that. But especially, boys and girls, I want you to find a way today or over the weekend to say thanks to your mammies and daddies. Because as I get older and a little bit bolder, I'm all the more grateful for what I got from my mother and father, and the education that they got and that they gave me, and the way that they helped me engage with the school here and to learn and to grow. So we want you to say in a nice way, whatever way you'd like to say thanks to your mummy and daddy in a special way today. And to give good example in that way, Ricky, would you go do the necessary? Of course, my My father, as you know, is died a number of years ago, but I give thanks for him every day. He was a great man, and we remember our loved ones who have died, who have guided us and been good role models for us. But thankfully, my mother is alive and well, and I've said thanks to my mother. And Ricky's going to make a little presentation to you as a way of thanking you, but also thanking all the parents and all the mothers and fathers who have been part of this school community and who continue to be so. She'll be awfully embarrassed and mortified now, as if I had chosen anybody else out of the crowd. And it is appropriate, I think, to thank the mothers and the fathers, because they are critical to any school community. And I want to encourage the parents that are here to acknowledge your role and to say that you work with the school, you're part of the school community, and the other parts, the teaching staff, the ancillary staff, and the boards of management can't do anything really without your help and cooperation. And it's a great partnership. So, may God continue to be good to us, may God continue to be kind to us, and to bless all the boys and girls here who will be in the school, and to bless all the families of the parish. I want you just to stand for our prayers.
Let us pray for all the pupils who studied and all the teachers who taught in Drumlee during the past 175 years, persevering through famine, war and hardship. Let us also remember our more immediate past pupils who are currently sitting exams or awaiting results. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
We pray for the present pupils of Drumlee, together with their parents, the teachers and the staff of the school, the Board of Management, the Parents Association, and all those who have helped to make Drumlee such a splendid and modern centre of education. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for the Church, the Pope, bishops, priests and religious, and particularly today, exactly 175 years after he established Drumlee National School. Let us pray for the infatigable Father James O'Driscoll. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Guimish our son, Muinsher Kilvihil, Muinsher na Heron, agus an down a lig. Gareva guing shikon, agus sonas, snablinta roing amok. A hirna eishling.
A hirna bicansa, agus eishling.
Let us pray for the sick, the poor and the underprivileged in our community, and for all who are suffering stress or anxiety at this time. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for everyone who has contributed in any way to the establishment, management and development of Drumlee over the centuries, as in managers, boards of management, principals, parents and politicians. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. Let us just pause for a moment to remember other prayers and intentions. Lord, hear us.
Lord,
we ask the prayers of Mary. We ask her to pray with us and for us as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners. Gracious and good God, bind us to you this day and all the days of our lives. In your love and mercy, listen to all our prayers, spoken and unspoken, but all made in trust and confidence through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
you, Lord God of all creation. For it is through your goodness that we receive this bread that we now offer you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For it is through your goodness that we receive this wine that we now offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us, to be pleased with our lives, our gifts, our struggles and sacrifice that we now offer you with humble and contrite. Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice and gifts will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look kindly upon our service, O Lord, we pray, and that what we offer may be acceptable to you, and lead us to grow in love through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For through his Paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works. For you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so with the angels and archangels, with all the hosts of the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Holy Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the cup to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It'll be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be here in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your people spread throughout the world. Bring us all to the fullness of love, together with Francis our Pope, and John our Bishop, and all your people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. We remember especially deceased past pupils, deceased members of staff, deceased people who have helped in any way to the contribution of life in this school. We remember as well other family members and friends that we pause to remember. Remember these and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them now into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. For it is through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. So let us stand. Said to your apostles, peace I leave you, it is my peace that I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith and goodness of your people, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Spread the sign of peace. You go that side and shake hands with people and give the sign of peace. You go that way and then come back. Don't fall. Off you go. Front row. Go around to the very back. Make sure you go all the way to the back.
Peace is flowing like a free.
some of these boys and girls have futures politicians the way they should be. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, and have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, and have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, and grant us peace.
Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. And blessed are we who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that you should unwrap my feet. Only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
For anyone requiring a celiac host, we have some celiac hosts, so you might come to Father Pat if that's the case. We'll distribute in obvious places.
Sunrise, lighting the sky, cast Christ.
Pardon?
Body of Christ.
Body of Christ.
Question I was, do you dance? You dance?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. No.
No. We have to take you on a tour, I think. The Lord is my rock and my fortress. My God is my saving strength. Of scripture in this context, given that it's clearly rooted on and near a rock here, this school, but its foundations are firm in a community that is strong and committed. So we might stand for our final prayer. Let us pray. May your healing work, O Lord, free us from doing evil and lead us to what is right. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This Mass is ended. Let us go forward and proclaim the gospel in the way we live our lives. Thanks be to God. Last year. So you know when there was a mighty wind, the Holy Spirit was around. So. You hold on to the ball. You hold on to it. You be the captain. You can sit back in your seat.
Thank you.
of Drumlee School to address you. Father Tony, Father Pat, agus aguine uisle. Fáilte roimh go léir chuig an lá speisialta seo is éil na Scoil Náisiúnta Drumlee. 175 years is an extraordinary achievement for this little country school. Father James O'Driscoll, that inspirational parish priest of Kilmichael, foresaw the value of the new national education system and used it to better lives for his beloved parishioners. He and his nephew, also Father James, battled through the famine and the upheaval of the 19th century to improve conditions for all. He believed in the value of a good education and appointed the 20-year-old Callow Callaghan as the new teacher. His faith in him was indeed good, and within a few years there were nearly 300 children enrolled. Sadly, the famine depleted the numbers, but Drumlee survived and marked many important milestones on the way. Children attended in Drumlee for the first 100 years had to walk long distances and endure hardship to attend school. But even then parents saw that a good education was a passport to a new life and went with it. Drumlee survived land wars, ambush and the loss of population to grow and prosper. And by 1990, its first 150 years, conditions had already begun to improve. The first extension was in 1999. We thought we were in heaven, but of course, time does not stand still, and we again outgrew our building. With the help of a hugely supportive parents and excellent boards of management, we took on our biggest project to date in 2009 and 2010. Our beautiful building today is the result, but we never forgot the past, and the old school is still here. Our school is so much part of the Kilmichael community, and that community has always been so proud of our achievements. Drumlee would not be what it is today without our wonderful children and their supportive parents. The work they have put in to prepare for today is testament to this. Thank you to a great parents' association and a hard-working board of management under the leadership of Francis O'Riordan. This school has always had great teachers and staff, and no school could have better than the team we have at present. Mary, our deputy principal, Julie, Linda, Norma, Mary, our SNA, Joan, our secretary, and Ricky, our caretaker. Thank you to them all. It is great to see so many past pupils here today, people who haven't been in the school for many a long day, and I hope that you enjoy today. But before I finish, I have a letter that came to us this morning. I am delighted to send my best wishes to the pupils and staff of Drumlee National School as you celebrate your 175th anniversary. Generations of Irish children have spent their formative years in Drumlee National School. Today, past pupils, now located all over the world, remain united in a great affection and gratitude for the place they will always remember as their school. Today, a new generation of young people are building their own happy memories of their lives at Drumlee National School. They are memories that they will carry with them throughout life, along with the ethos and values of the school, as they go on to leave their own unique mark on their communities, their workplaces and their society. I congratulate all those currently involved with Drumlee National School on this special occasion, and I wish you every success for the future. Michael D. Higgins, Uachtaráin na hÉireann. And I hope that you enjoy the rest of today. Go raibh míle maith agaibh. In 1990, to celebrate the 150th anniversary of Drumlee School, Memories of Drumlee, a Country School, was published. This book, very popular with both past pupils and past pupils and their families. And in fact, a few weeks ago, somebody walked into the local shop looking for a copy of it, and luckily John Collins was able to find, I think, his very last copy. Now, a lot has happened in the last 25 years, so it was only timely that another book would be published. Technology in 2015 has allowed us to have a lovely book in colour compared to the original black and white. However, on the other hand, data legislation has restricted us, and you will see groups of photographs, but their names will not be attached because we would have had to contact every single pupil individually for their permission. History is culture, and I'm sure this book, in its own way, will enrich the history and culture of Drumlee School and Kilmichael. So now I invite Father Tony to officially launch Drumlee National School, Kilmichael, spanning the three centuries. Thank you.
You're probably sick of hearing my voice at this stage, but as the man said, books are to be read, not launched. So I'll keep this kind of brief. Again, just a thank you. Say thanks for inviting me to be part of this day. And I suppose when I got the invitation, it's given me an opportunity, I'm sure, like the rest of you past pupils, just to reflect on some of the memories of my time here. And the memories are very happy ones, and I think the section of the book that I most enjoyed, and it's there's some really interesting stuff in the book, but the section that I most enjoyed, I think it's called From Behind the Bench, or In Front of the Bench, or but it's basically reflections of people and their stories and their memories, like I'm saying to Sheila, do you remember this thing we used to play called Hunt? Basically where you chased each other around the yard, and if you touched someone, they had to join hands, and you go off chasing somebody else who was running around, and if you touched them, they had to... What do you call it now? Chain gang.
Chain tag.
We just called it Hunt. See, we were much more simple in our days. We called things what they were. But I like your name for it too. And Gerard Tank, I was telling Gerard Murphy that I hadn't thought about them. It was still in there, but the school tours that we had, like going to Cork City, as you say, it was like going to a different country, and the tours to Garnish and Bantry and the other tours that we had. So, and that section, I'm not going to mention every person who's contributed there, but that section I found particularly interesting because it brought out memories that we had, and I'm sure that the book will do that for so many other people. The other thing that stands out for me is the smiley faces. And this morning I had them here in 3D looking up at me, and I suppose that's what it's all about. It's about these boys and girls today. While it's good to look at the memories, it's about acknowledging what's going on now and what the needs of these boys and girls. And this book does remind us, we know we live in interesting times and the world is always changing and there's always something new. We live in a time where there's a lot of change. But when you read this book, you're reminded that there must have been a lot of change in the 1840s, in the famine. And there must be a lot of uncertainty and challenges and difficulties. There must have been an awful lot of challenges and difficulties in the early 1900s. The War of Independence, the establishment of a new state. There must have been around the war and World War II, the 60s. I don't remember them. Anyone remember the 60s? There were times of change too. So we're always living through times of change, but I suppose every generation has to deal with the changes and the challenges that we see our children, that we will pass on a better world to them, and that we will prepare them to pass on in a way a world that they will change for the better and be part of for the better for themselves and for others. Like when you grow up, what do you want to be? Anyone know what they want to be?
Science.
A teacher,
a
farmer,
a scientist,
a blacksmith,
a guardie, or either
a fireman or a garda.
A farmer or either a garda.
A priest.
Excellent. I'll give you the application form now. Good man. A Zumba dancer. I wanted to be one of those too. This wouldn't let me in.
An engineer.
An engineer.
Ice cream seller.
Engineer and an ice cream seller.
A forester.
A barrister.
Yeah.
A barrister.
A jockey.
A jockey.
A soccer player.
A soccer player.
Who are you going to play for?
A farmer. Barcelona.
Barcelona, that's ambition.
And then Tommy.
A farmer.
Soccer player.
Soccer player. A designer, a farmer.
A teacher.
God help us, a teacher.
A gymologist.
A zoologist.
A gymologist.
I don't even know what that is. You'll have to explain it to me. A gymologist. Is that working in a gym?
Gym.
Okay.
Like a
football. Football and hurling.
Player.
Excellent.
Doctor.
A doctor.
A singer.
Actually, I want to be.
You're changing your mind from being a priest.
Quick. Soccer player,
doctor. What are you going to choose now? But you can see these boys and girls have dreams and hopes. Where the world, they see the world as their place to live. They see any profession that's open to them, any way of life they want, and they have dreams and hopes. And isn't that fantastic? And isn't it fantastic that they're in a school that will prepare them for that as good as any other school in the country and in the world? And realise that, boys and girls, you're in a fantastic school. And when you realise that there are boys and girls in this country and in this world who don't have the opportunities and the schooling and the things that you have, and always keep those in mind, that you have been blessed. And maybe there's something that you need to give back to those other boys and girls whenever you get a chance.
Some people don't go to school.
Some people don't go to school. Aren't they very unlucky boys and girls, aren't they? So the book, as I say, is... I enjoyed the sections that I have read. And as Francis says, it also includes sections on the parish. I think it's a very good production. I'd like to commend those involved in it. I know these kind of things take a lot of patience and effort, and they're not put together easily. So again, just to thank those who have put it together. And I don't know where it's available. I don't know how much it is. You're not giving it away, I suspect. You're not giving it away. I know there's not one for everyone in the audience. But it's a nice thing to buy and have it in the house, and maybe to be thinking even of Christmas presents at this stage. It's a good old Christmas present or something. There's a good reason to buy it. And I'd like to just commend it to you. And do I have to declare it officially launched? I declare it officially launched. Thank you.
Reverend Fathers, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the committee here today of Drumlee National School, the people that have come here today now to support this wonderful event, we're all very delighted to see you here. It's a very special occasion here for everyone, and we're glad we've got a fine day. So thanks to Father Tony and Father Pat for celebrating the Mass here. Now, as a past pupil here myself, I'm delighted and honoured to be here, and it's great to see the work that everyone has done here today. So I want to make a presentation here to Father Tony, and it's special for me because we were classmates, I suppose it's only a few months ago really, Tony. We both ran around the yard here, the stony, gravelly yard. We kicked the football. We had a few games of hunt, I suppose. We're both
chain,
in short.
Chain tag,
future reference. We both had the short pences running around here. Like everyone else did, a few of us walked to school, as Tony said earlier, which doesn't seem to happen now, but there were some good times here as well. We were marched in and out to the school here by Miss McSweeney, who's here with us today, Miss O'Mahony, God rest her, was also on duty at that time.
My dad was in the school.
He sure was. So, I'm not going to say much more, but I want to make a presentation here to Tony. As I say, it is great to have our ex-pupil here and fellow classmate.
Thank you.
And we won't charge him the €20 for the book. We let him out with a warning this time. But there's also a little token of our appreciation for coming here to us today.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. At least I forget and get into trouble. I must bring down Father Pat as well. I'll have to face Father Pat next weekend.
There's no need.
Another book for Father
Pat
as well.
Thank you very much. I will go to buy it. Thanks, John.
Unfortunately, there isn't one for everybody in the audience, but anyhow, it is €20. It is for sale here today, and it will be available in the local bookshops and on mylocalbooks.ie. And we've had very generous advertisers and sponsors, and we thank them, and we would like you to support them, please. Now, Drumlee National School has had many talented past pupils in the academic world, sport, enterprise, music and art. And while we might talk about our past pupils, the present pupils here today are very talented, especially musically. We heard them on 103 FM recently, and thanks to Ger Wolf here today, the visiting music teacher to the school, he has made a CD. And Tony, you might see them on tour. I'm sure it will be a number one hit, and it is being launched today. So now let's relax and enjoy some entertainment from them.
It's our anniversary.
Back.